Have you ever watched a nature documentary where the narrator is secretly watching an animal drink water at the lake or chase its next meal? Chances are that you have. When you watch such a film, you are watching a variation of the observation method. Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I'm going to show you four different types of observation methods that can be used in psychological research. Observation is a very powerful tool of psychological inquiry. It is an effective method of describing behavior. In our daily life, we remain busy observing many things throughout the day. Most of the times, we do not even notice what we are seeing. We see, but we do not observe. We are aware of only a few things that we see daily. Have you ever experienced such a thing? Let me know in the comments below. You may have also experienced that if you carefully observe a person for some time, you come to know many interesting things about that person. However, a scientific observation differs from day-to-day observation in many respects. It is important to know that making good observations is a skill. A good observer knows exactly what to look for, whom to observe, when and where the observation needs to be made, in what form the observation will be recorded, and what methods will be used to analyze the observed behavior. Types of observation. Number 1. Naturalistic observation. When observations are done in a natural or real-life setting, such as animals being observed in the jungle or adolescents being observed at school, it is called a naturalistic observation. In this case, the observer makes no effort to control or manipulate the situation for making an observation. For example, you may want to study risk-taking behaviors in teenagers. You might choose to observe behavior in different settings, such as a rock climbing wall, an ice skating rink, or a bumper car ride. After you operationally define risk-taking behavior, you would observe your teen subjects in these settings and record every incident of what you have defined as risky behavior. This type of observation is conducted in hospitals, homes, schools, and daycare centers. Number 2. Controlled observation. Many times you may need to control certain factors that determine behavior as they are not the focus of your study. For this reason, many of the studies in psychology are conducted in the laboratory. This type of observation is therefore called controlled laboratory observation. For example, research has been carried out in sleep laboratories where electrodes are attached to the scalp of participants and changes in electrical activities in the brain during sleep are observed. Such an observation can only be done in a laboratory. Number 3. Non-participant observation. In this type of observation, you will observe the person or event from a distance. Here, the person being observed may not be aware of the observation taking place. For example, you may want to observe the pattern of interaction between teachers and students in a particular class. There are many ways of achieving this goal. You can install a video camera to record the classroom activities, which you can later see and analyze. Alternatively, you may decide to sit in a corner of the class without interfering or participating in classroom activities. The danger in this type of setup is that the very fact that someone, an outsider, is sitting and observing may bring a change in the behavior of the students and the teacher. This is known as observer effect. Number 4. Participant observation. In participant observation, the observer becomes a part of the school or the group of people being observed. Here, the observer takes some time to establish a rapport with the group so that they can start accepting him as one of the group members. This approach was used by Leon Festinger in a famous study into a religious cult who believed that the end of the world was about to occur. He joined the cult and studied how they reacted when the prophecy did not come true. In order for this type of a research to be successful, he would have had to join the religious cult and become part of the group so that they would open up to him and reveal to him their thoughts about the prophecy. However, the degree of involvement of the observer with the group being observed would vary depending upon the focus of the study. The advantage of observation method is that it enables the researcher to study people and their behavior in a naturalistic situation as it occurs. However, the observation method is labor-intensive, time-consuming, and is susceptible to observer's bias. Our observation is influenced by our values and beliefs about the person or the event that we are observing. We see things as we are and not as things are. Because of our biases, we may interpret some things in a different way than what the participant may actually mean. Therefore, the observer should record the behavior as it happens and should not interpret the behavior at the time of observation itself. Despite these shortcomings, the observation method is widely used in research in psychology. If you found this video helpful, remember to share it with others and please subscribe to the channel. As always, thanks for watching.